the best thriller or horror film are Blood Inn, Learning Hebrew, or Breakdown Reward. And the prize goes to, which is not really brilliant for a London Film Festival, but the prize goes to a film that's made in Greece called Breakdown Reward. And I think the director has come all the way from Greece to receive his prize.
Joanna, I don't know if you recognise her, has been working behind the bar for half the festival, and the other You know, we've just got so much great films that come in, and it's really difficult. Okay, the best film nominees are Times New Roman, The Beach House, The Art of Repair, which was an extremely good film, Mark Duggan Untold, Modern Babylon, and The Casuals. And the best film for the Portobello Film Festival 2012 goes to The Casuals. I really hope Cass Bennett's here. Cass, where are you? Cass Bennett here. I'm sure I saw someone waving to me. Come on, guys. Give these guys a round of applause. They're like skipping us. They want pictures and like feed them to the door. Like 80s. Thank you.
Thank you so much. For once, Cass Bennett is speechless. I had no idea. Full story's not being told. My name's too much associated with the other story of our project. Put together a team. On the right of me, Ian Stuttart, renowned film documentary maker. Well, first met in 85, making a really good documentary. And on my left, the young talent, Alexandra Thomas. Well, things been here before with a short film award. And we tried to get commissioned, but as an unknown company that I formed, we never got a commission. So with the help of some sponsors, we self-raised the funds with IBF Roofing, 80s Casual Classics, Fila, and we decided to sell the story with everyone in the UK, right, the last working class culture, the football casual. And from Scotland to Wales to England, with the debate of who started it, from London, Liverpool and Manchester. We interviewed 53 interviews. And I think the director was not with us, Mick Kelly, and said, you need 6 for our documentary. We interviewed 53, and with their support, the passion really moved us in the year we made it, because it's a story that said, it's about time someone learned this story. And the problem we had was archive. It was unrecorded at the time because the media only concentrated on the violence. Yet this story was a big social movement. And unlike all the other social movements and cultures, it's left the legacy today into today's designer fashions and the high street fashions. But there's another story behind that, the social commitment. What did it mean to the guys and the casuals? What did it mean to them? Why, even the females we interviewed. What did it mean to this subculture? We managed to get that into an hour and 15 minutes. And from word of mouth, the film's been well received, but we never reached the wide audience. So we come to things like Portobello Festival to hopefully get the recognition. But never in my wildest dreams, you know, our goal was just to get a screening. I expect to be standing here and recognised by the biggest support of independent films. I've never done a speech, so I'm going to cut it short. But kid you not, that this is an unknown journey for me, because when I got an email during the week, people said, Cass, we'll come on and support you. What time does it start? I said, I don't know. There's a film called Golden Twenix. I think it's after that, you know. The song's playing, this is what Golden Twenix was. You know, I've been on the Google to tell up, like, all connected local. So trust me, this is a new journey for me. But in the making of Casuals, I stand here proud of Ian Stuttart, Alexandra Thomas, and with the support of Mick Kelly, the director of the Jews, between us. Thank you.